Welcome to our new video. In this video, we are going to discuss about gate electrical engineering weightage analysis and preparation strategy. And this is especially useful if you are in the final days of your preparation. Maybe you have like 1 month or 1.5 months for preparation. This would be handy. So let's go into the weightage analysis first. So the first subject we are going to look at is electric circuits. We have a data for 3 years, 2014, 15, 16, and two sets per each year. You can see over here the 2014 set one, number of 1 mark questions are 3 and hence 3 marks, number of 2 marks questions are 2, hence 4 marks. Total electric circuits are 7 marks for the 2014 set one. Similarly, in set 2, 5 marks. 2015 set 1, 9 marks and 9 marks, 11 marks here and 11 marks over here. So 2014 average was 6.5, 9 and here 11. Total electric circuits average we can expect 9.8.83. Therefore, this year it could be like we can expect from 8 to 9 marks. 8 to 9 marks possibility is there. Hence it is a greatest weightage. It is also good weightage. We can concentrate on this subject. Next subject we are going to look at is electromagnetic fields. I can say this is one of the least important subject if you are in the final days. If you are in the starting days, you want to improve your rank and then you have a lot of time for gate preparation, then definitely don't leave any subject. And the weightage goes like this. 2014 average was 3 marks, 15 average, 5.54 and finally 4.16. Like you can expect 3 to 4 marks from this subject. This is electromagnetic fields. And then we have signals and systems. This subject requires a lot of practice, and also circuits as well. It requires a lot of practice. Average is like 2014 8, 6 over here and total 6.66, and therefore it could be like 6 to 7 marks you can expect from signals and systems. So you cannot leave this subject also, it is important. Next subject is electrical machines. 2014 it was 13.5 and here 13.5 and 12, and this is the subject which is having the highest weightage for gate triple E electrical engineering, I mean 12.5. and in actually there are like more than two sets also, but I have got data for two sets for simplicity sake. In some sets the total marks were around 18 to 20 also, in some cases total marks were. So we never knew. Even 2017, if you're writing now, then you may get 20 marks also from this electrical machine. So the most important subject is electrical machines. So you got to prepare electrical machines first perfectly with 100% efficiency. And next, power system. This is the next important subject, having a 9.83 weightage. And 2014 average was like 10.5, and this is like this. Concentrate more on load flow stability analysis, such kind of topics which are very tough actually. And the next is control systems. This is equally important as circuits. 8.83, both are having the same weightage, and yearly average was 6.5, 10 and 10, and even this year it may be like you may get around 8 to 10 like that. 8 to 10 possibility is there. So this is about control systems, and this requires a lot of practice. Three subjects mainly, they require a lot of practice. They are circuits, control systems and signals and systems, because they involve a lot of mathematics. More mathematical applications are there. And electrical measuring instruments, and this is a core electrical subject, but it is having a least weightage 4.43. and you want to improve your rank, then you concentrate on these things. If you are in the final days, you can ignore also, there is a chance. If you are having only 1 month left, then you can ignore the subject EMF, electromagnetic fields. Concentrate on electrical machines, power system, control system, those circuits and all. And yearly average was 6, 4.5, 2.5 marks like this. And even if you are writing for 2017, then you can expect around 4 marks, possibility is there. And then the next we are going to look at digital electronics and microprocessors, and averages 7 marks out of these 3 years. This year also you can expect around 6 to 7 marks, and a yearly average was something like this. This is about digital electronics, and then we have analog electronics. 6 marks is the average. 2014 average was 6.5, 2015 was 9.5, 2016 2 marks. I'm sorry, this is not 2 marks, 4 marks. It's wrongly printed. And average goes like this. And then we have another power electronics, core electrical subject. So 2014 was 7, here 6.5 and 10. This is also can be considered a potential subject for electrical engineering, triple E paper, double E paper, 7.8 marks. This year you can expect around 8 to 9 marks also, there's a chance for power electronics. So we have done with the weightage analysis. So based on this weightage obtained, now we have to prepare, we are going to study about the preparation strategy. Now which subjects you have to give importance and how you should manage your time. So far we have seen the weightage of all technical subjects, and we do have mathematics also, mathematics and general aptitude. Mathematics and general aptitude marks are fixed, that is 15, always 15. So this requires a lot of practice. Mathematics need a lot of practice, very important. So mathematics is very important in terms of practice. And I have categorized the total syllabus into two categories, potentially very high important, like red alert. That is the reason why here these subjects are in red and these are in blue. They are cool. It means if you are in the final stages, then I mean like you have 1 month, then you can ignore these subjects more or less. But definitely at any point of time, you cannot leave these subjects. Very, very important. You see electrical machines having the highest weightage as per our analysis so far. 12.5, 9.83 power systems, control systems and circuits nearly same, 8.8 power electronics 7, and if you take total of them 46.99, and mathematics and general aptitude at any cost we cannot leave, because you have studied mathematics many times more than this technical subjects. Therefore 46.99 of these subjects and 15 mathematics you cannot leave, and so you have 61.99, means approximately like 62 marks you are getting if you properly manage time in the last 1 or 1.5 months by preparing these 5 subjects plus mathematics and general aptitude. So 60, if you have crossed 60, then your rank you can expect less than 300 to 400. Means your rank will be less than 300 to 400, your rank, if you properly manage with these 6 parts, mathematics, machines, power systems, control systems and like that. And if you are expecting very top rank, like top 100 like that, then you should have more time also. Then if you are having like 3 months to prepare, then that is more than enough to crack All India rank 1 also. Then you got to concentrate first more on these subjects, these 6 subjects, and then these are a little bit least weightage subjects. You can concentrate over here. So however, the core subjects, core electrical engineering subjects are important compared to electronics part. And the parts which require most practice are mathematics, control systems, circuits. These subjects require a lot of practice. This is also practice oriented subject, and this is, yeah, as I said, practice. And then machines, be thorough with machines. Out of machines, more important part is the transformers are induction machines. They are more important than other parts. Power systems, you can study power system stability, voltage control, load flow and transmission line parameters. And as far as generating stations is concerned, you are going to study only generation economics, which have this load flow, load curves, based on the load curves, load factor, demand factor, all such sort of problems based on this, mostly problems. And they are like very easy. You can practice the previous questions, it's good. Control systems, you require very thorough practice. Prepare well for control systems, mostly problems oriented, no theory. And even circuits also, there is no chance of like theory questions, all problems only. Power electronics also you can prepare well, read it from the PS Bimra book. Don't go for detailed study at this point of time. If you are at the last moment, just go for previous questions based on these subjects and practice as many number of problems as you can. And if you have still time, if you find a little bit easy anything, you can have a look at these four subjects also. And don't forget to take grand tests. Any grand test is suggestible. I don't suggest you take particular grand test. Any provider, any grand test provider is okay. Take grand test as many as possible. Last 15 days. For 15 days, you have to continuously take grand tests. So make sure that before last 15 days of your GATE exam, you should have completed these six subjects thoroughly. Make sure you complete it thoroughly with 99% efficiency minimum. Okay, maximum 100% if you are an ideal guy, you can do it if you can. And these four subjects you need not look at if you are in the last one and a half month. In this 15 days of grand test, you can cover up these four subjects also. This is to cover these four tests. Grand tests are more than enough. So make sure you have definitely grand tests. You never miss a grand test. 15 days, take daily at least two grand tests, totally minimum 30. So 20 to 30 grand tests are suggested to get good rank. So if you are thinking you are having less time for GATE preparation, need not worry. You still have a lot of time. Make sure you complete these six subjects. So you can complete these subjects, you are getting 60 marks. Okay, 62 marks, which is very great. You can get even in PSUs. There are more chances you're likely to get into IITs, and also you can apply for PSUs, no problem. So you can just follow this strategy, these six subjects thoroughly, plus grand tests for 15 days, means like 20 to 30 grand tests, depending upon your stamina. And these four subjects you need not study. I can say if you are in the last 1 month, you need not study. You look at these subjects. You can just cover these subjects on the top during the grand test. That will be enough for these four subjects: digital, analog, electrical measuring, and EMF. So that's it, guys, for the GATE weightage analysis and preparation strategy. I wish you very best for your GATE exam. And if you have any doubt, you can reach me out at my email, and you can message me, you can WhatsApp me as well. I'm providing my number also. So that's it, over and out.